Hey everybody, welcome to another lesson of learning Japanese. Today we're going to cover the grammar pattern that is nari ni. So nari ni translates to one's own style or way, and how it's going to be used, it's going to be added right after a noun word basically when it's necessary to emphasize that particular noun's way or style in the situation. And so in this video title and description, we have this grammar pattern marked as nari ni because that's going to be the form that is most frequently used. We have the particle ni there because, as we should know at this point, the ni particle is commonly used to mark an adverb that is modifying a verb action that follows. So that's how nari ni is usually used. We use it to modify a noun, and then a verb action follows right after it. But the alternative form, nari no, also exists to modify a noun that is then going to describe a noun right after it too, as well. And so we'll provide one example of that in the example sentences that we have for this grammar pattern, which we'll actually cover right now. Okay, so nari ni as one's own way or style. Our first example sentence for this grammar pattern is, Boku wa boku nari ni jinsei kan o motte iru. And so what is this line going to translate to? Well, it's going to say something basically along the lines of, I have my own way of viewing life. So let's break down the sentence bit by bit. First up, we just have boku, which is going to translate to I. We have the particle wa marking boku as the topic of the sentence. Then we have our grammar pattern. So nari ni is going to appear, but first it's going to have a noun to appear right before it so it can add on to that noun. And so that noun is just going to be, again, boku, which means I. Then we have our grammar pattern nari ni. So here we have nari ni translating to one's own style or way. Since it's being used with the noun boku, which means I, this is basically going to be my own style or my own way. Then right after that, we have the word jinsei kan, which is going to translate to basically worldview or life view, way to look at life, something along those lines. It's going to be a direct object because it's marked by the particle o right after it, and so what now is going to follow is some kind of verb action. And so that verb action is just simply going to be motte iru, and this is going to be the verb motsu in its te form plus iru to mean to have. And so altogether now, this sentence is just simply going to read, I have my own way of looking at life. So we should see here how the grammar pattern nari ni is emphasizing this idea of my own way or my own style of looking at life. For our next example sentence, we have the line, Jibun nari ni koko made ganbatte kita. And so what this line is going to translate to is basically, up to this point, I have tried hard in my own special way. Let's break down this sentence bit by bit. First up, we have the word jibun, and this is kind of a perfect word to use with this nari ni grammar pattern because it naturally means one's own way, or one's own style, and jibun translates to basically oneself or yourself. So of course, jibun nari ni is just going to translate to that again, my own way or my own style. Then right after nari ni, we have the word kokomade, and this is just going to translate to until here or up to this point, basically. Then right after that, we just have the verb action, which is ganbaru in its te form, plus the going verb kuru in its ta form to add that extra nuance of to get here up to this point, basically. So altogether, the sentence is just saying, I have worked hard to get to this point in my own special way, basically. 自分 なりに ここまで頑張ってきた. For our next example sentence, we have the line, 彼女は親の言いなりになってきた人です. And so what this line is going to translate to is basically, she is someone who has lived exactly the way her parents have told her to. So let's break down the sentence bit by bit. First up, we just start with 彼女は, and this is going to basically just mark the topic of the sentence as her or she. Right after that, we're going to have our noun that we're going to use with the nari ni grammar pattern, and that's going to be a noun of a noun modification. So the first noun in that modification is going to be oya, which is going to translate to parents. Then we have the particle no to invoke that noun of a noun modification. Then we have e, which is basically the noun form of the verb u, which means to say. So this will translate to basically things said or words. So oya no e nari ni is going to translate to in the way of her parents' words or in the way of everything her parents have said. Then now what follows is going to be our verb action. That's just going to be the verb nari, which means to become in its te form. Again, followed by the going verb kuru, which means to come in its past ta form to basically emphasize this nuance of have come to this point doing that action. So what this is kind of invoking is this idea of up to this point in life, she has gradually become this person who lives in the way of her parents' words. Of course, right after kita, we have the word hito, which is a noun that means person, of course, to make that whole part before hito, modifying hito. So again, let's look at the Japanese again. 彼女は親の言いなりになってきた人だ or des. That's gonna be she is a person who has lived exactly the way her parents have told her to, basically. Or exactly in the way her parents have told her to. Alright, now for our last example sentence. So we're gonna use nari no instead of nari ni to basically modify a noun to use it to describe another noun. So for our example sentence, we have the line, neko wa neko nari no aijo hyogen o suru. And so what this line is gonna translate to is basically, cats have their own way of showing affection. So let's break down this sentence bit by bit. First up, again, we're just covering what the topic of the sentence is. Neko wa, neko translates to cat, and wa is marking as the topic of the sentence. Then we have our grammar pattern, but first we need the noun that's going to be used with, and again, it's just going to be neko because we've already kind of established neko, cat, as the subject of the sentence, so it makes sense that we're going to be talking about their way or their style. So hopefully, unsurprisingly at this point, neko nari is going to be cat's own way or cat's own style. And so right after nari, we have, of course, no, because we're going to be using this in the alternative form where we're modifying a noun to follow with another noun. And so that other noun in this example sentence is going to be the word aijo hyogen. And this is going to be two words. Aijo translates to affection, basically, or love, and hyogen is going to translate to expression. So this is going to be basically way of showing affection. And so this is a noun, so usage is clear here. So neko nari no aijo hyogen is going to be cat's own way of showing affection, basically. And we're going to use this noun as a direct object. So we put the particle o right after aijo hyogen, and then we have the verb suru, basically, to say that cats do that. So cats do their own way of showing affection. We're more naturally just going to translate that to cats have their own way of showing affection. Neko wa neko nari no aijo hyogen o suru. And so there we go. That's using nari ni, the grammar pattern that means one's own way or style. And some example sentences to show the context that they're used in. There are definitely a lot of other ways to express the same general idea using different grammar patterns, but hopefully this is a good addition to your grammar database, and you can start expressing how you do things in your own way, your own style. And yeah.